Hey everybody, how's it going? This is John, I'm with Jay Rasenstein. And we get a lot of calls from customers in reference to the H2 Pro from RHG on how to change the DI filter. So I'm going to give you a quick rundown on how to quickly do that. So come on over and let's take a look. First thing you want to do when changing the filter is disconnect it from the machine. These are all push fittings, so that's your first step. Second would be loosen those clamps, the Cobra clamps, from the housing. Next step would be pull the filter loose. If you are changing multiple filters, do one at a time. That way you're not replumbing it later on, crossing the lines. It makes things a lot easier for you. Remove the pin. Remove the pin as a lever. Remove the cap. Inside, if you want to take a quick look at that, you can see the filter. We can go about doing that. I like to stick the old hand right in there. And it'll slide out. Remove the filter. This is a good filter. So we're not actually going to open up a new one, but we're going to replace this one back in there. You'd open up the new filter. Place it back within the side, depending on the situation. There's lubricating and the sealing product that you can apply to the around the edge of the cap. But this has plenty on it already, so we're not going to need to add that. As you can see here, reattach the cap. One thing you want to make sure before you really push this all the way down is that you're lined up with your pin. Nothing worse than going through all this and having to take it all apart again because you're not lined up. Slide it back into place. Reattach the tubing. These are all push fittings. It's pretty easy. Especially if you have smaller hands. And reattach your Cobra clamp.